Well, Matt, this is the recording of my Northeast Dungeon Siege 2021 contribution to the pre-siege events. And I did a Dark Souls 1 run for the event, and it was a very good time. Shout out to T and the whole NEDS crew. It was a super good time. We just did a cool little Dark Souls 1 run here and talked about life, dungeon, and metal philosophy, and had a good time. So make sure to check out Northeast Dungeon Siege on Twitch. I'll have the information below. The rest of this week, the week of March 29th, will be 3 nights of gaming, then 4 nights of dungeon synth and music, and it's gonna be fantastic. It is fantastic, so pay attention, concentrate, and enjoy this VOD. It's just at this point promotional for the fest, and if you want something to watch that involves Dark Souls right now, here you go. Hail. Well, Matt, what's up, everybody? I'm Higo Damask, and we're going to do some Dark Souls 1 challenge runs today. Well, we'll do one challenge run. Howdy, howdy, aka Magic Peanut. How's it going? Yeah, so special thank you to Tirith for hitting me up on behalf of Northeast Dungeon Siege. Happens to be my birthday, and it's I don't care about my birthday at all. But this gave me something to look forward to, totally, so thanks so much. Anyway, I do... Thank you so much, yeah. Anyway, I do podcast work at Monad of Creation. It's just basic truth stuff and self-mastery. I do Twitch streaming from Software Games, Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, Dark Souls 1, sometimes Dark Souls 3, and I love Funeral Doom, I love tasteful death metal, and atmospheric black metal. So today I got a playlist of my favorite dungeon synth with a few metal tracks thrown in there. And shout out to Retcon Greg, that was fantastic. That was a nice mix of a lot of aesthetics and things that I adore. No Dark Souls 2. DS2 is a good game. I'm not a DS2 hater, believe it or not. So, Retcon Greg, hails, dude. That was fantastic. Good opener to the show. I used to be in band myself, so this feels very reminiscent of playing in bands. It's super cool. It's like a culmination of all the things I love, you know. So thank you for welcoming me to the community. I've had my eye on the fest. I know Drawn did the track for my podcast for the first 15 episodes. Drawn Gregorio Franco. He played last year. He's a homie. And now I'm just meeting more of you, so this is awesome. Hail. And let's get started. So we're doing Dark Souls 1. I play remastered version, and what we got going on. All right, chat looks good. Let me make sure my playlist is shuffling. And I made a 2-hour playlist, so let's get going. We're happy to have you here. Thank you so much. So let's get going. So what we have here is a file at New Game Plus 6. These are I have a lot of files, right? So we got a file at New Game Plus 6 called Cute Name. Cute Name. And she's at level 1, so that means that she doesn't level up at all. Which means that she doesn't get stronger from stats. No stats, no leveling. Can't spend souls. So, in Dark Souls, if you're unaware of how this game works, you use souls to level up your character, and leveling up your character makes you stronger, and it lets you wield specific weapons and things. So this character, I did 6 playthroughs. I hope it loads. Very long loading screen. I did 6 playthroughs, so it's max difficulty. Each new game cycle, the difficulty gets harder. So what we're doing here is we got a level 1 character at the hardest difficulty. I'm on the 7th playthrough. And so that means the enemies have increased damage output and increased health. So it's all the enemies, the hardest you can get them in base game without modification is this. Honor Chug, it's a lot of both. So it's locked. What did I do? Oh, I'm right here. I have to go talk to Oscar. So we just came through the Undead Asylum, which is the first area in the game. And yeah, we're gonna play the game, guys, as if it's the first time. I just fought the boss first encounter, so now I'm running through the Undead Asylum to get a key item that opens up that door I could not open. Right now we're listening to Old Tower. Deep within my somber castle halls. I know there's some hot take opinions on Old Tower that I'm not too keen on. I just really love the music and I really appreciate the work. So I enjoy it for what it is. And it's fantastic. But yeah, if anybody's got questions about anything regarding Dark Souls, reality, me, or if you want to say something, go ahead. I stream on Twitch at HigoDamask144 pretty often. And we're going to open this door. We just got an item. I should probably talk to the NPCs, but we're going to sort of run through it. I didn't think you got regen from Sanctus without stat requirement. Yeah, it seems busted, right? I mean, you shouldn't, honestly. If I were designing the game, I would say you have to level up Faith to be able to use it, right? So I'm cursed right now. There's a skull over my humanity, so I go to the stat menu to look for my humanity. And humanity right there on the bottom of the stat menu, you want 10 of those when you use chaos weapons because they give you more damage. Chaos weapons scale with humanities. So reason, chaos weapons until I die, and then if I die, I'll lose humanities and we'll switch over to another weapon. But I need to speed up because what I'm doing today for the stream is an interesting route I thought of on my own. I'm gonna let this play, it's gonna sound sick with the music.
asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords. Lordran.
These load times are making me nervous. I don't know what it is. It's not responding. And at Land of the Ancient Lords. How long have I played Dark Souls on Twitch? Since 2017. I don't know why the load times being odd. But it's whatever, it's fine. Yeah, so since 2017, I really got into these games with Dark Souls 3, which is typically considered the best one by most people in the community, but I mean, it's all boils down to opinion, honestly, and how much enjoyment you get out of them. People like to have opinions about a lot of things in reality, but 2017, and I did casual playthroughs for a long time. I did just had fun, like before I went to work or went to my society job, and I would just play games. And the games I would play were the From Software Soulsborne games. And all right, so yeah, I eventually met some people who did these things called level one challenges. So they encouraged me to try it because I was getting pretty good. And it's, you have low health. Oh, the game is being a tweaker. Yeah, I don't know what that is all about. It looks like a speedrun now. It's not good. I wonder why it's doing that. I might close some software. I might close Discord. It gets weird. Is the elevator even gonna come? Another thing, these modern games, I heard Dark Souls but never actually played it. Spent 8 hours grinding for the ghost knife for soul and the quit. Really? Okay, so yeah, what I would recommend if you ever go back, this isn't looking good. What I would recommend if you ever go back is getting the reinforced club and the lower undead in the undead burg with the undead merchant. I don't know why it's doing this. Yeah, dude. I'll try a few things. It could be my RAM, because I'm running the camera, I'm running the banner, the game. Shouldn't be my MP3s, shouldn't be anything else. Yeah, Reinforced Club. Alright, let's see if it fixed it. Reinforced Club, I just quit the game out and loaded back in. Reinforced Club and the Undead Bird, I'd get that. Upgrade that, it's a really good weapon. You can get it to plus 15, even plus 10 is fine. You don't even need to upgrade it all the way to get good damage, but there's a lot of better options for weapons. Okay, it's totally not even working. So let's see if I have Prepare to Die Edition installed and we can do something on the fly. Northeast Dungeon Siege, I will turn on my data so I can get Discord messages from you on my phone. I closed Discord. I am now going to close Chrome because Chrome is a hog. And I'm just going to real quick check on something. And you guys can enjoy this old tower track. It's gonna play more music. It should just be like 2 minutes. And check my integrity of game files. So, yeah, you could go to the Undead Burg and pick up the Reinforced Club, get that to plus 15 solid damage. You could take that to all the way max new game with the Reinforced Club. Super good damage. You can also do the Giant Blacksmith Hammer, which is all the way in Anor Londo. Do that. There are a lot of options. Including even the mace would be good, but generally the best ones, like for OP damage, would be Reinforced Club and Blacksmith Giant Hammer. So what acts are you guys looking forward to this week? Last year I wasn't able to hang out as often as I wanted to. You do the DLC 2, it's gonna be a nightmare with the split damage. Split damage on the Blacksmith Giant Hammer? Or with Chaos Weapons. Rang an Alder Deep. Awesome. Alright, so now we're listening to some Blood Incantation. This one is Subterranean Eon, I think. Yes. Alder Deep, nice. I'm gonna have to check out that set. Alright, validating is taking too long, so we're just gonna reopen DS1. And it looks like I'm just having a RAM issue, maybe. I cannot tell. So we're gonna play it. Hey, what's up, Willow Tree? Welcome in. Kingsfield for tomorrow. Field of Blood Incantation. They're great. Alright, so it's launched. Oh, is it because I've an Adobe Acrobat Reader open? I bet that takes up RAM. Bet you anything that takes up RAM. Apologies for the RAM issues. No worries. Alright. No worries? Cool. Hey, at least you got metal and dungeon synth, right? Okay. It's not a real fest if there aren't little quirks to party through, right? The DLC kicks my dick when I try for an elemental build. Interesting. Yeah, I love going plus 15, dude. Plus 15 on all the physical damage, it's plenty. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's RAM or if it's DS1. It's odd. Plus 15 Claymore with quality build, oh baby. Plus 15 Claymore, yes. Very good. Claymore's good, man. I even like Claymore one-handed. Alright, so I will not quit out. We might just do kill and skip. I want to kill Gwyn, you know? So, his great moveset. Yeah, one-handed R2s are nice. So, it's running. We'll see what happens. And if it keeps screwing up, I can play some of my old challenge run videos, and we can hang out and watch, listen to Dungeon Synth and Metal, and talk about Dark Souls. If the RAM is an issue, but right now it looks fine. The message I'm getting is that I should play Dark Souls sometime, maybe. Yeah, so Willow Tree, Dark Souls We've been talking a lot about mechanics and gameplay, right? But the story is fantastic. It's all about, honestly, I like to look at it in real life allegory, so I'll start there. The real life allegory is all about determination, discipline, learning, self-mastery, and just overcoming your challenges. And item descriptions, yes, you gotta read the item descriptions. And there's a whole theme of light versus dark, and they're really ambiguous about good and evil in this game, and I love things, personally, I love things that are ambiguous about good and evil, or don't have a good and evil paradigm whatsoever. And there's a lot of implications in terms of, you know, if the gods are holy, you know, if the gods actually care about lowly humans, you know, what actually is evil, and then also just the basic path in life and embodying yourself. But a lot of the embodying yourself stuff comes from just getting through the game and looking at it esoterically. Other than that, the gameplay is super fun. You press a button to roll, and you get these things called invincibility frames. And that happens sometimes. And I don't know where the enemy is, the Black Knight. He will one-shot me. So there's a lot of things you can do. Mechanics are great. You got a variety of weapons you can use. Game gives you approximately 2 minutes of lore, entire game if you don't go looking for it exactly. Bird of Pygmy. Yeah. So hopefully this next area loads. We're about to find out. So easily forgotten. Falling off catchy cliffs. Yeah, look at that. This area is not loading. I'm a speedrunner now. Should have done a storytelling RPG. Well, it's loading slowly. That's what I'm realizing now. Like, I could just do the whole run, like, with it loading shit. Like, that. I mean, I couldn't, actually. I don't know. You see, the NPCs won't load that I need. Well, this could be interesting, actually. Okay, yeah, the collision boxes for the stairs aren't even loading, so now I'm stuck. And I'm gonna hit a gravity death box, probably. So something's wrong with either the RAM, or I have to, yeah, big F. This is not planned. Something's wrong with the RAM. Worked on some album art while listening. What's up, Frozen Deer? So, I'm going to have to, this is Tarun, I believe. Tarun is, yes, the water spirit. Honestly, since we're on a time limit, we could watch one of my old, I have a recorded Deathless run actually at Soul Level 1. So I can mute it, I could commentate over it, and that would work fine, honestly. I just don't have the RAM to do this banner and other apps, it seems. Or I could load up Dark Souls 3 and see if that works for real-time gameplay. So, yeah, we'll do some science. If Dark Souls 3 runs fine, Dark Souls Remastered on my computer is the thing that's fucked up. So, I don't know if it's the banner. I don't know if it's my computer. Kill the banner if you need to. Okay, we'll figure it out. I want to keep the banner because it's super dope. So we're going to find out right now what the problem is. Not a big deal. Okay. I'll figure it out. Real quick, honestly. It's not going to take a long time to test. Interesting game actors. Well, I mean, honestly, I'm gonna save up for more RAM if it does turn out to be a RAM issue. So we'll find out, guys. I'm enjoying being here. Like I feel the energy. Like I'm in an ineffable cavern with a bunch of Dungeon Synth fans, so I'm fine. I hope you're fine. But I'm hoping, so there's no way I can actually know if you're feeling it, so. Let's see. If Dark Souls 3 loads faster than Remaster, then something's wrong with Dark Souls 1, and not the banner, and not my computer. Doing great. Thanks, man. You were really good. The album is fantastic. Super dope. I was doing this earlier before the siege, just a casual DS3. I mean, the load screen was messed up. Alright, yeah, if DS3 is fine, it's gotta be something else. Because DS3 takes up more processor and RAM than DS1. Does anyone know the new Tauren record? I don't think it's that new, I'm just newer to it than others. Actually, what am I talking about? I sound high or something. Chaos Wyhinder Run? I mean, this can't be RAM. It can't be RAM if DS 3 is going well. Because this game is way more intense than DS1. So I'm thinking my files are corrupted or something. Hey, thank you so much, Northeast Dungeon Siege. Thank you for being understanding with these sort of technical difficulties. I guess they're technical difficulties. I mean, we're still hanging out and listening to Dungeons. Let's go to a populated area. Things happen, friend. Let's get an H for Higo in chat, please. Thank you. Hail. Dark Souls 1 is one of the worst optimized PC ports in existence. It's legendarily bad in terms of stability. Pretty bad. You're right. When you think of Elder Scrolls, and I really wish they'd make a new one. Yeah. I love Oblivion. So my dropped frames are 144, and my username is 144. It's pretty cool. I'd like to see one for the cat people's homeland. Yeah, elsewhere. That'd be really cool. Are you talking about this song? Frozen Deer? This is Ensiferum by the Dividing Stream. Suffering through DS1 with DS Fix was a real challenge of an experience. Watching you play DS. Oh, got you. Alright, so we're gonna run. Oh! Yeah, for sure. So this is Dark Souls 3, by the way. We switched games because we're testing. I haven't played the remaster on PC, but I have no idea if it's better. It is better. It's a lot more stable, but I mean, I don't put it past that game to still be optimized trash, you know. So I think DS1 loads areas differently. I really don't want to kill the banner. So honestly, I'm gonna go with my own I'm gonna go with my own. Well, it's better live, so we could test the banner, Tirith. I have options. We're gonna test the banner. And if the banner is the issue, you already gave me permission to not use it. Unfortunate, but if it's not the banner, if it is the banner, I'll stream live. Where is it? And if it is the banner, I will stream with the banner and play some recorded challenge runs that I have recorded, and we'll talk about it and hang out more. I hate to remove that banner, it's awesome. And it looked like it probably took some nice work making. Yeah, it's, I don't know, I can't tell. Now we're listening to Mournful Congregation, White Cold Wrath Burnt Frozen Blood. This is my favorite Funeral Doom band. They're just legendary all around. Alright, let's see what I can do. This character might be RIP though. Because I don't have warping. Wait, no, I have Homeward Bones. So I have a warping item that can take me back to a checkpoint since I'm stuck behind this. Alright, let's hope. Let's just hope. There's not much else we can really do. So, if this works, since we only have an hour left, it'll be a speed run, and we're going to do a pretty fast run through, and I'll use a glitch at the end of the game to get to the last boss, and we'll try to do it deathless. That'd be pretty cool. This is working. I need to upgrade my computer because that file was giving me issues, I guess, with the gameplay. Apologies. I wasn't really expecting that to happen. How does everything sound and look, chat room? Dungeon folk. Let's buy the thing. I don't know if I need the Crest of Artorias. This lets us get to a certain area. It's fine. Okay. So this next boss we're gonna do is called Gargoyles. The Bell Gargoyles, and I'm gonna use the Reinforced Club on them. And we are cursed, so we use this shield to regenerate our health, and we use this to drain our health. And we use this to give us more power when our health is drained below 20%. And this also gives us more power when our health is being drained. So this counteracts this while we're cursed. and the enemies are doing more damage, so we can't get hit at all. So I'm gonna play safe so we don't waste any more time. I wasn't safe. So that gives me an opportunity to teach. Now we're gonna switch to the giant blacksmith hammer because I lost my humanities, and that means I can't have the damage I want. When you don't have humanities, you don't get the damage you want. Because the chaos weapons scale with humanities. And when you die, you end funeral doom for Dark Souls funeral. Yeah, exactly. So this weapon is very good. Now we have humanities again, but it's fine. Yeah, Mournful Congregation. Very fantastic. If you're into the slower, more zen, transcendental funeral doom. So I'm doing a strategy right here a lot of no-hit runners do. You lure them over like this, the hollows. Mournful Congregation Live was unforgettable. Ooh, you saw them? Yeah, I can't imagine. They're literally my go-to for most situations at this point. Whether I'm going to sleep and I want some sort of power. Not that they give me my power, but some nice supplemental energy via funeral doom. If I listen to metal when I'm going to sleep, it's them. If I listen to metal when I'm going on a long drive, they'll be a part of it. They're just simply fantastic. Alright, let's go around. In the forest, Stella Natura 2013. I'm gonna have to... Looks like you're a subscriber. You'll remind me that in the Discord. So, by going around and doing all this nonsense, we avoid this room up here that challenge runners typically call the Hollow Room. It's called the Hollow Room. Thank you so much. It's called the Hollow Room because those hollows that I lured around are typically in there. And I just don't have any time to waste at this point anymore at all. So I was playing safe. And we're going to do my ring setup. We're going to do the Clorinthy Ring because the Clorinthy Ring gives me stamina. And the red Tearstone ring will give me a damage boost. And we have humanity again, so I think I'll use the Chaos Hammer. And we're going to use Power Within. And once our health is at below 20%, we're going to switch over to the Sanctus Shield, and it's going to negate the health and leave it at 20%, and we'll get a double damage boost. It's very OP. I typically don't like to use it simply because it's so strong. And we're at New Game Plus 6, so everything will one-shot a soul level 1 character. Most things will. Especially these gargoyles. Any bosses typically will. Like that. When did you see Mournful live, Leech? Lech. I keep wanting to say Leech. Lechelver is the name. Cool. Music festival is still in Atura, the Tahu Forest, and the Sierras. Oh my god. That sounds fantastic. This in the mountains? Yeah. I'm feeling that right now. Kind of amazing. They brought them over, Wanderer was supposed to headline, but Gaal was still in the band and got his knighted. So yeah, I made a very silly mistake and died to gargoyles. Not supposed to happen. Wild times in general. Yeah, so I got into metal. Metal was really my responsible for me getting into dungeon synth, honestly. And I got into metal because of Blood Incantation back in 2016. I was really tired of punk rock. It was just 4/4 punk beats, and I was in a bunch of rock and punk bands, and just like, you know, looking for something more. And I was really interested in interesting metal, right? So that's when I found some black metal, and I found Blood Incantation, and they were the most interesting to me at the time. And then I got into Doom, got into Funeral Doom, got into more death and black. And then I found, in 2019, I found Old Sorcery, I think was my first gateway into dungeon synth. Yeah, Old Sorcery was it. Wait, I gotta appreciate this part. Yeah, Old Sorcery, and then I found Ornotorporate, I think, and it was downhill from there. Yeah, it was just absolutely downhill from there. And now I just listen to metal, roots reggae, and dungeon synth, man. Some other stuff too, like some cool electronic music, you know. Right, I gotta pay attention because I'm not dying to these nerds again. I got into dungeon synth from listening to Summoning High School, hell yeah. It's dope. Alright, that was an optimal damage. Do you see how my health is not drained to less than 20% yet? Once it hits 20%, I'll show you how strong it gets. This actually works out, because then I can use that damage boost on this NPC that I'm going to kill for humanities. forgot to host this on my channel. It's fine. I hosted Retcon, that's what matters. Instead of hosting, I can pour a French press. Yeah, I have a summoning track on here. You're going to be happy to hear it, Frozen Deer. I have Grey Heavens from their earlier record. Why isn't Power Within draining anymore? I don't know. Is it because I healed? I could die here. It doesn't matter if I do. I would like to get these humanities if I survive. We don't have much time, but to illustrate this buff, I'll just chill out and show you. My favorite band followed by Have a Nice Life. Cool. Alright, so now I put on this healing shield and it fluctuates and keeps my health at this specific percentage instead of draining it all the way. So it's like mad damage, you know? And it doesn't appear to be working as planned. So we're gonna grab these humanities and get out of here. And go on to the next boss, which is Quelaag. It's very OP. It's pretty silly, honestly. We could do kiln skip. We have an hour, okay, so we could do Quelaag and come back up. Do that. We'll do that. We'll do a regular Quelaag. We don't need to sense gate skip. I was gonna do another skip, but I don't feel like doing two skips for this. We'll at least do an Ornstein and Smough fight, I think. And then a Gwyn fight. And if you guys want to see other bosses and other Dark Souls stuff, since I have unlimited time on my other channel, and you might like to have another cool place to hang out at on the internet, I'll be doing those other fights in this game elsewhere. But that's not what this night is about. This night is about getting hyped about the fest. Yeah, summoning's Lurgburz. Lurgburz, right? Lugburz. Alright, since we're on time constraint, maybe if I die to Quelaag, we will do Sen's Gate Skip. That'd be fun. That'd make it interesting. If I die to Quelaag, we'll do Sen's Gate Skip. I'm gonna fight this NPC. Most of the time you'll see runners do kick him off the ledge. But he's fun to fight sometimes. It's very fun to fight this man. And I might even be able to knock him off with an R2. Leave me no choice. Yeah, I mean, it's so busted. Not chance, my friend. Not chance, my friend. This is shuffling my 2-hour playlist. Yeah. I want this extended. I want to make like an hour extended version of this. Lull me to sleep. So we're going to the next boss, is Quelaag. It's down in Blighttown. Blighttown is a very hated area, especially for newcomers to the game, but once you learn how to navigate it, it's not that bad at all. But yeah, first playthroughs, this place, pretty trash can. Not the best. But we have a master key, so we went through a shortcut, and we'll come up through here. They call it Upper Blighttown, so typically, during the first playthrough, you might not know about the master key, and you may have to get here a different way than you're seeing me execute this moment. So I have this ring called the Rusted Iron Ring. It lets you run in deep water. This band is called Artesia. They're featured on the Dungeon Synth Archives YouTube channel. And this specific record is from their Bandcamp that I picked up. Artesia, they're a French like neoclassical world dark ambient project with nice cellos and strings and stuff. Very pleasant. So we're gonna let the health get down to Red Tearstone Ring range, and then we will fight Quelaag with the buffs we intended to use earlier, but didn't. How's chat's 2021 starting off? Reminds me of Ophelia's Dream, yeah. I don't know Ophelia's Dream. It should be working properly, so let it drain a bit. And then we'll switch to the healing shield. Why he naked? He's naked. Let's see if it works. He's naked because... She's naked because we don't need to wear armor, and wearing less armor makes it so you're faster and have better rolling in this game. And my health is not working properly. I don't know if it has to do with my game glitching out a bunch and the coding in the game is just wrong right now. This is just a train wreck. I'm gonna get hit and die. Oh, never mind. I saved it. And it's just gonna be a slower fight because now I have less damage. It's not the worst damage though. This fight is not my favorite. Dark Souls 1 is notorious for having very boring fights in the Dark Souls community because it's a little older, very simple, and this fight, dying to this fight can be a big meme, as the internet would call it. Things are not always the way you want them, but the redeeming qualities of this game are fantastic. If you're new to the series, it's a must play. Now I have invisible lava. This fight is very inconsistent, if you ask me. Apple it up, dude. Welcome to the siege, brother. So if you guys ever check out my channel or my podcast work, Applebee Patios, he did all my artwork for it, and I actually brainwashed him. Actually, I like to call it benevolent mind control, which is actually just influencing, because everything in reality is ultimately programming. So I turned him on to Dungeon Synth a little bit. And now he's here, and he's gonna join us this weekend. This week. This whole week. 7 days. 7 entire days. So, welcome in, dude. To this awesome community. That I am very honored to be a part of. Encourage everyone here to stick around all week if they can tune in. Hope you're doing good, dude. I am. I'm doing really great. And I'm skipping cutscenes, chat, because we only have an hour left. I would like to get end credits, even if I'm using a glitch, to speed things up a little bit. Yeah, I hope you're doing good as well, Apple. Hope you're doing fantastic. So we're going off to Sense Fortress now. And Sense Fortress is, once again, a pretty notoriously difficult place for newcomers to the game. And it's got a safe route you can figure out through practice. And it's filled with snakes. It's pretty fun. I'm good, enjoying a beer after a long day. Nice, man. I don't think you're alone. So the bonfires in Dark Souls are checkpoints. They're very nice. So I get them because we die often at soul level 1 at max difficulty. Alright, let's do Sense Fortress. I'm not gonna use any rings, it might make it more entertaining. It will make it more entertaining. To succeed or fail. I haven't done this in a few weeks, so it should be interesting. So I just did a little trick right there in Dark Souls 1 and 3 that you can abuse, called quit outs. And you quit the game out, and it warps your character back to whatever position, whichever surface they were last at. So if you fall off a cliff and you quit the game before you hit a death box, a gravity death box, you can reset your position. And I'll do another one here that resets the boulders in Sin's Fortress. And don't worry if you plan on playing the game, these aren't really spoilers. I watched so many speedruns before I played Dark Souls myself, and when I played the game, I forgot, like, everything I've seen speedrunners do. And I bring up speedrunners because those are typically tricks that speedrunners do. Like, casual playthroughs, not necessary. But I'm on a time limit now. So I had technical difficulties. Alright, made it up. Made it up Sense Fortress. Enjoy that on your first time. It's a great journey. It teaches you patience. This whole game teaches you patience and how to enjoy bleak realities. And allegorically, it can help in real life if you really try to learn these games. Just like music, like if you make dungeon synth or any sort of music, and you know, You require discipline and creativity. This game requires all those same things. It's pretty interesting. So now we're listening to Morgan's Lament by Dim. From Compendium 2. No, I'm wrong. Is that the name of this song? I'm gonna have to look at it. So this guy has these bombs. Alright. Cool. We don't have to kill him. He'll typically throw these into the boss arena, so I like to jump up here and just destroy them real quick. Because it's simple. And he doesn't have any bombs anymore, so... The game is coded so it gives him infinite bombs, when in reality, he's just got, like, 5 up there. But if you kill the 5, his infinite bombs go away. It's quite nice for the player. Sometimes, if you do this properly, I'm not, you can do enough damage to his feet to where he'll fall down. And then you don't have to really do the fight like this. He'll just fall down. We're off to An Orlando. I will play this cutscene, half of it, but music, you can't, even when you turn the music off in the game options, the music and the half of this cutscene plays, so I'll skip through it. And we're going over from, you know, the slums of Lodron to a nice, beautiful An Orlando, full of, you know, from what I've discerned through my time playing this game, the nobility and quite possibly the angelic lineage that's not so nice to all sentient life in Lodron. But I digress. As a chosen undead, I will go figure things out. Right? Figure it out. So this bonfire is really crucial. Otherwise, you have to run all the way back up everywhere I just did. And that's not fun for anyone. Yeah. This is Rune Realms. This is Fog of Time. Rune Realms? I don't know. I don't see Rune Realms around that often, honestly, in Dungeon Synth circles. I think they're more with a New Age stuff, but I do love Rune Realms. I mean, it's all music, right? It's all beautiful. Beautiful sounds. This record is called Seeking the Lost Castle. So I'm using the Ring of Fog here. It's an item that makes you invisible, but what it does to the enemies, it makes them aggressive at half the distance. So it lets you run through this section with ease. Comfy Yoshi. So now I take off the ring. This gargoyle will try to come fight me. Because it sees me now. and it might succeed in hurting me. Nope. Should try to attack me and give me some space to keep running. Yes. Once again, all these things will one-shot me. My calculations are correct. My intuited assumptions, honestly. Just off of a good bit of knowledge, I guess. And so, that being said, I'm trying to be very careful. Lightning? No lightning. Alright. Section is also very hard on the first playthrough. It's fun to learn. Alright, I'm gonna just knock him off. He should fall off with this. Stand up, fall off. I missed the parry. Go back doing some laundry. Enjoy. So this time, since we changed the levers, the main bridge across Anne Orlando will be activated. I could wear my sorcerer's boots. I love the black sorcerer's boots, they're very nice. They won't help me at all. Truly. So I have done no-hit runs in the past, and deathless things, and other like low-damage challenge runs and some no-roll. And honestly, what I enjoy the most is just running the game with different weapons and experimenting challenges. Because with a no-hit run, if you're unaware, that means you can't get hit, right? So if you're trying the challenge, you have to restart often. Or if you're doing no death, you have to restart every time you die. And that type of thing can be very stressful. That is another learning lesson in and of itself. We got lightning this time. Roll. And I think I'm going to kill the knight just so it's faster. Right here. I'm gonna get hit in the back. Okay. Later. This is Dim again. This is Andariel's lullaby. From Dim Compendium 1. Alright, now we're nearing the next boss. Got about 50 minutes left of this stream, so thank you for everyone who's hung out. And I encourage you, you know, as being a part of the opening acts of Northeast Dungeon Siege, pay attention. And tune in the rest of the week. Be a good time. So right now I'm getting fall damage. so I can set up the buffs that I want. The buffs, buff means power up, you know, like something that makes you stronger. Oh shoot, okay, I did that. Like Mario or something. And I'm not sure what happened. I do know what happened. I was not using the proper ring setup. I have to use... Yeah, that's what I was doing. I have to use this for it all to work properly. That being said, we'll just jump right into it and deal with it. Deal with what happens. So let's go to this boss. This next boss is called Ornstein Smo. I do enjoy them. I should switch. Yeah, I'm not using the most optimal weapon right now. Okay. Now we're listening to Thief. Very good high fantasy dungeon synth. Very good high fantasy. This daydreaming century, ever miss with Comfy Synth? Yeah, Comfy Synth is really cool. I actually got into... What's that? Pastoral Daydreams? It's quiet. This is so quiet. Pastoral Daydreams... What's that artist? Chronicles of Jest? I think that's Comfy Synth. I would love to find more Comfy Synth, though. That is something I would enjoy. Because I do like music like nice electronic music like Onomatoguchi, Snail's House, all sorts of stuff, and Comfy Synth is very awesome. Starting a Comfy Synth project, just got a new Kumbala and illustrations. Wow, Frozen Deer, that's awesome. I mean, honestly, like, if you, I'm genuinely interested, so, but keep me updated for sure. It's awesome. I'm just not doing the right things, right? It's fine. You guys get to see some cool sections of Dark Souls 1, hopefully some incentive to play the game, hopefully a good night, and a good start to the siege. I'm liking the energy so far. We'll share in DS Cult group on Facebook eventually. Oh, I need to join that. I made a Facebook recently. It's got my personal identity on there, just fine. Typically, go. Am I not getting RTSR? Not. Name. Yeah, I love it. Frozen Deer's the name. I'm thinking for my project since the name. That's fantastic. I really like that. Speaking of comfy music that I like, this is Onomatoguchi. It's not dungeon synth, but it is a synth track with no, not much technical instrumentation going on. But it's a interlude, gymnified, whatever that classical art, classical music piece is called. They did their own rendition of it, and I thought it would fit pretty well for this stream. Thank you, Alderdeep. I've seen your Bandcamp before. Ales. Thank you. Alright, we're gonna do Power Within first. Thank you. Then we're gonna jump down. This should give us RTSR. I will do this. Quit out, switch my volume up. I think this death metal song is gonna be very loud. Yeah. This is Mortiferum, Abhorrent Genesis. It's not comfy. It's comfy to me, but it's not comfy in the traditional sense. And it looks like the buff is working properly. And he's giving me the opener that I prefer. It's comfy, I have the album this is on. Dope. Yeah, this track is great. You have the split? I didn't get the split, but good music for art making. Nice. What were you talking about? The gymnophede. So yeah, we're just jumping off this for fall damage, because other things will one-shot. We don't want one-shot. One-shot means that you die in one hit. So right there, I was not looking at Smo. So when you fight this boss, you really want to keep an eye on both of the enemies. And I made the mistake. Like, I deserved that death. I deserved that because I made a mistake that I could have prevented myself. That too. Perfect music for this battle, yeah. And dying a lot. This next part is really sick. This song, whole song is sick. So who was at the siege last year? Who was a part of the siege last year, and who was a spectator last year? I was such a newcomer to this whole genre. I mean, I have a hypothesis that people who gravitate towards dungeon and metal, like, share similar frequency. And what I mean by that, like, the energy of your consciousness and your mind, your behavior, like what you care about and how you act, you know. I've noticed those similarities with a lot of people who like the darker things in reality and artwork, and it's pretty fascinating. So it's cool to finally connect with the dungeon community. It's my first. I live under a rock. Nice. Yeah, I barely hung out last year. Allie, what up? You're catching the last of my set. Hail. You should stick around and follow Northeast Dungeon Siege for the rest of the fest. It's a good time. Sure, yes. So we're on phase two of this boss, and I'm doing a lot of wrong things, by the way. You're the new Sangus Shabog? No, I haven't. Is that some death metal that I should check out? I need to rebuff my setup. Any moment. Is that gonna give me enough time? Awesome. That was a close call. Right there. Black and war metal. Black and death metal. Nice. I love black and other categories of metal. So with this boss, I decided to kill the skinnier guy first, because it's honestly, typically, once people know this game, they typically go for this second fight, because it's generally easier. It also depends on what you know, but I typically do this, and especially for the fest, I'm going to do the easier boss, because I'm not wasting any more time after what happened, especially. With all the technical difficulties that happened. All right, Ornstein smell finished. Boss looks like Evil Buddha. Well, he is a fallen angelic, pretty much. He defends the hierarchical angelic structure of the Dark Souls universe, which keeps these humanoids that my character is pretty much in a reincarnational death trap. Of course, it's like partially my own personal headcanon of the game, but the boss we're about to kill put a curse on humanity. It looks like your mom. So since we only have 27 minutes left, we're gonna do... I'm sorry, we only have 30 minutes left. We're gonna do a glitch that gets us to the last boss. We could do a few other cool bosses. Frozen Soul, I have not. What do we have time for? 30 minutes? I could do a cool boss. I can do some cool things in 30 minutes. Thou shalt perish in the twilight of Anor Londo. Do four kings and Sif. We'll go look at a dog with a sword in his mouth. Frozen Soul, I have not. Morgan, Badmon, 420, I have not. So, time. We'll actually just do, we'll do the kill and skip, and I'll show you some cool fights I've recorded. Because with time, I want to display as much as I can. So we're gonna go to do a glitch that gets the last boss, you know, like this quickly. And I'll show off a glitch, and it's partially challenge run because we're doing it with restrictions. Restrictions imply what we're doing, like no leveling, those types of things, max difficulty. So we jump down here, punch the snake. You don't have to punch the snake, but I'm down here. And you put this item called the Lord Vessel on this tree stump and opens up these portals all around the world map that unlock the required bosses to open up this big boss door that I'm about to do a glitch through. Because the route I wanted to do, we spent a lot of time fixing the game. So I have other content we can look at and listen to the rest of my playlist, listen to the rest of the playlist I made, and chill out. But we're just gonna beat the game real quick and watch this cutscene. And got some Ornithorpret playing. Shit. This is from their, not their, I think it's their most recent split with, Isagrim, yeah. How you say it? So what you do with this glitch, you rest at this bonfire or wherever, and what you do is use a warping item. I use Homeward Bones, and you close the game during the cutscene at a specific frame. And I run this game on a regular hard drive right now, I think, so it's not, it's too frame perfect, and frame perfect means you have to get it exactly on the proper frame of the animation, but we'll see if I get it soon enough. Yeah, this split was called the Heathen Kingdom. Fantastic. We can get the skip, but we can hang out until I get it. Might have been too early. So a skip is called a skip because what you do is you skip portions of a game. And so we're skipping a huge portion of the game to get to the final requirement to beat the game. And in a traditional challenge run, I would not do that, but I've spent way too much time in this game, and I'm just trying to display some cool things with the dungeon siege. I'm going early. So, Homeward Bone, use. So you quit it out with Alt F4, and then you reopen it, and if it's at the proper frame, puts you in the boss area. In this game, it's really cool. You acquire the souls of all the bosses you fight, and you can use them for points to level up more, or you can save them later to trade in for weapons. And in this character, I just save them for the most part. In Homeward Bone, Return to the Bonfire, Last Rest of That. That's the item we're using for this. Yeah, I heard the bonfire there, so that was too early. That felt good. I really love Ornithorpret because they can do dark and mystical so well. It's so beautiful. There we go, we're in. So now I can't die to this boss, otherwise we have to do that again. Because there's no checkpoint in this area. Yeah, there's no checkpoint in this area, so I have to do well. Zero humanity, so we're gonna pop, we're gonna use 10 humanity, because with 10 humanity, it's an item that gives you more health, but it also scales with chaos, like I explained at the beginning of the stream. You pop 10 of them, and now I use the Chaos Club, which will be the most damage I can do on Gwyn. Did you mention earlier you podcast, what's it called? It's called Monad of Creation. I actually named it after Mournful Congregation's record. Because at the time of creating that Instagram account initially, I was super into that music, and I still am. I still listen to it all the time, but I couldn't think of a cool name, so I just used that. And it happens to line up with a lot of philosophy and ideas that I have about reality. Cool, thanks, no problem. It's mainly about truth-seeking and esotericism and reality. I plan on doing it for a while, but anyway, that's what it's called. I think you said you do a podcast too. I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to hear about it, man. Maybe we could share. Thank you, Slammin' Con. Appreciate it. So yeah, we gotta get through this section without dying. Otherwise, the skip that just took me about 3 minutes to perform, we'll have to do it again. So I'm gonna pay attention. And not die. I need to ring swap here. I hear a knight coming. Okay, I'll ring swap up here. It's not safe right here. Not safe right there. I'm going to quit out, which resets the enemies. I don't recommend doing that on the first playthrough because it's sort of cheap. And sometimes it can't be pulled off properly anyway. So, no, I don't want that. We're going to parry this boss, which is a move you perform like that with the parry button. And it deflects attacks, and it gets you a critical hit opportunity, so. This boss can look like a joke sometimes, but he can still kick your ass if you're not careful. So that's not good. Controlled it. All right. So we did gargoyles. We did. Thank you, Breesmelf. Thank you. Thank you, Northeast Dungeon Siege. We did gargoyles. We did Quaileg, ONS, Ornstein Smo. Then we did a skip and we got to the last boss. So we have 20 minutes left. Yeah, thank you. So I still have content to share. I can roll the credits, and I need to head to the restroom, which will take like 2 minutes. Enjoy the rest of this track, and I'll be right back. Go for it? Cool. Hails to everybody who's joined so far. I will be right back.
Upon the world. Our
What a great track to finish this on. Super dope. Alright, thank you, Tirith, for letting me empty my body. So, yeah, that was Dark Souls 1, guys, and I'm going to show you my favorite boss in the game. We're going to close this out, throw the banner back up. So when you finish a game and playthrough in this, thank you, Frozen Deer, for being here, and hope to see you all around this whole week. It's so awesome to be a part of this. It's super, super rad. And yeah, you start over at the beginning of the game when you complete a cycle of this game. So I'm going to show you some bosses I didn't have time to fight live, and I have them recorded on my old YouTube channel, and that also means I can bring back up the media source, because I don't need RAM. I'm not playing a game, so apologize for this dross, but I think it's worth it. Get this beautiful banner back up. Alright. So we got 15 minutes till I have to end, so let's check out Manus, Father of the Abyss. Super, super cool boss. And we're gonna open up YouTube, because I used to do challenge runs on and there it is. Let me screen capture. I'll show you some of the cool bosses with cool challenges I've done. You know, things are what they are. I didn't have time to do them live, but it's all good. I had a great time. I'm thankful for that. Alright, so let's go to Manus, Father of the Abyss. Cool boss right here. The quality is pretty trash. Oh, it's not too bad. Go to 480. So, on this boss, I did Soul Level 1, New Game Plus 6, which is what we just did. But it is with a weapon called the Kestis. Alter the fastest movement and dodging if you're encumbered. Yeah, you want to be unencumbered. Yes, exactly. You want to be quick. Let's play it. This boss is very awesome. And transform it. Bit centered just. Not even a hat. No hats, man. No hats, man. There we go. So this is Manus, Father of the Abyss, and I was doing a Kestis only. And at the time, I wasn't as aggressive as I could be. So this fight is 17 minutes long. I couldn't get hit. 17 minutes long. Cool boss. Very highlight of the game in my opinion. And so with this boss, he's got a phase 1 and a phase 2. So phase 1 is this moveset. He does that slam. He does some swings, and phase 2 is very interesting. So you get him to about half health, and then he starts doing dark magic. Very cool. Very cool to watch. And dark magic take some time to learn how to dodge and whatnot. Like that, you have to run inward and punch his hand. And he still has his normal moveset, but then a bunch of magic spells. Very, very fun, very dope. That one gets a lot of people. There's a secret item I won't talk about that you can get that can deflect that easy without having to run or dodge. Man is Father of the Abyss, my favorite boss of the game. My second favorite boss is the one I fought, the gold boys, Ornstein and Smough, the golden ones. Yeah, this dude is sick. And his Father of the Abyss. So, I'll show you my other favorite boss in Dark Souls 1. I did the same challenge on it. That fight was really bad. That was a 25-minute fight. This was just 17 minutes. This was called Black Dragon Calamite. You run over here. It's really beautiful, actually. So what's actually sort of cool about me showing you the bosses and not doing them is if any of you actually go decide to play Dark Souls 1, you're going to have to go discover them on your own. And once you do discover them, let's say you have nothing to do with your life right now and you're like, screw it, I'm going to play a game. I'd highly recommend this game. You don't have to. It's your choice, you know, but it's good. That's a dragon and I fight it for 25 minutes and I'm not sure why I chose to do this with my time at the time I chose to do it. But I did. It was a good time. And now I have content to show you when my computer doesn't have enough RAM to handle a lot of things at once. This is old sorcery. I can't pronounce the name of the track. That swipe attack, you have to stay to the left of it. That's a delayed tail swipe. Very fun. Very fun. So this is the same deal we did. Max difficulty, just less damage. This boss though doesn't have two phases. It's the same moveset the whole time. That's the only downside to Dark Souls 1. It's some of the bosses don't have diverse movesets. So we got 10 minutes left. Yeah, everybody, if you're lurking and you don't know what's going on over here at Northeast Dungeon Siege, well, I also don't want to like do the job of the people who talk after me. Just stick around this week. Keep an eye on it. It'll be a good time. If you like the sounds that are happening right now, you should definitely stick around. If you like chill people who probably like what you like, hang out. Good time. It's the same deal with this boss. I did Red Tier Stone Ring, so I got a little health, extra damage, super, super fun. And then, so yeah, I used to be Mephala 33, and it's a good boss to end this on. Oh god, not that one. Yeah, big thanks to Tirith Moon for just hitting me up out of nowhere and asking me to siege with y'all. Super great. Very fantastic. Thanks for spending time with us and sharing your Dark Souls knowledge. Right? No problem. It served a purpose, tell you that. Never thought it would serve a purpose in my life. 5 minutes, perfect. This boss is dope. Aesthetically, even if you don't know what the game is, this boss is aesthetically so dope. I think I have like a Ghost Data song playing in this, so. I guess I tried playing Dark Souls 3 on PS4. Oh, nice. Dark Souls 3 is good. I played it earlier today to get people over here from my channel. but Dark Souls 1 isn't mainly my thing. This boss is probably the most aesthetically pleasing. And for a dungeon synth fest, I think this is the best one to end it on. Thanks so much. Yeah, Frantic. Hell yeah, dude. And Winterstead? Perfect. And Guild of Lore? Perfect. I mean, it's good to meet all you guys. All you people. I'm not the best at the inclusive stuff. Looks like the boss from Gantt Zero. Hails. Yeah, Hails. Northeast Dungeon Siege. I assume Tirith is behind that. Yeah. Where am I? So yeah, this boss, I feel like talking about it. Just look how cool it is. You'll find it if you play the game someday. But I will tell you what I did. I didn't use any, I didn't use red tearstone ring in this. So we did today, but without buffs. Thank you so much for the follow. I guess my alert box is under everything. Oh, the alert box is tied to my other channel or something. Yeah, so, if you all would like to find out about my work, you can go to my panels and explore it there, or you can ask me about it now and I could type it in chat. But I do podcast, YouTube, and Twitch. Podcast is a little more serious. It's
from where do you hail?
The podcast is mainly like my teaching stuff about truth and esotericism and nonsense. And then Twitch is where I hang out, and I'll eventually make synth music on Twitch, as well as continue to stream games and have grounded, indwelling conversation with people. So I don't like to talk about myself, but, and then the YouTube is Dark Souls 1 gameplay with random like philosophy about Dark Souls and philosophy from my podcast with Dark Souls gameplay. Follow the smog to synth-filled lands. Yes. We got 5 minutes left of my set. Appreciate everybody. Yeah, I'd like to leave this on a good note. I mean, a lot of people are struggling right now and don't like to talk about it, whether it's financially, being frustrated with yourself, or being frustrated with the world, or hating yourself, or hating the world, or a mixture of a lot of things. And ultimately, it sounds easier said than done, and it sounds trivial and silly, but all that you need is within yourself, the power within yourself. And if you keep in check your discipline, you keep in check your attitudes and your behavior, you can do what you need to be done. You can do what needs to get done. Do what must be done, Lord Vader. That's it. Ended right in time. It's a cool boss. That was like 2-3 years ago, I think. Alright, so everybody, thank you so much. Make sure to stick around for the rest of the fest. The whole week. You know, it'll be a good time. Very good time. Okay, see you later. Later, guys. Enjoy the fest. Thank you so much, Northeast Dungeon Siege. I really appreciate it. That was fantastic. Everybody take care. Dungeon Siege forever, yes, Alderdeep. I look forward to your set. Look forward to all of it. So I'm going to sign off here. Let this track finish. And at 12 a.m. March 30th, I will press stop streaming and come back to chat room. Eternal hails. It's gonna rip. It will rip. Later, everybody.